Yeah. The future of Super Meat Boy. Right now, me and Tommy are... Well, first we're working on press for the release of the Xbox version, obviously. And then we have to throw ourselves into the Wii version, the PC version, the Mac version, and eventually the editor. So we will be in Super Meat Boy world for a good 6 more months, probably.
Yeah, probably around that.
After that, I think we'd like to close the book on the game and leave it there as what it is. You know, hopefully it'll be a little gem for people, and we won't fuck it up with sequels like other companies tend to do. And we'll make something completely new. If we ever touch on the IP again, it won't be Meat Boy being the main character, that's for sure.
Yeah. Let's see. Fans waiting for Super Meat Boy. I would say that... I'm going to say something from the heart, Edmund.
Do it.
That's okay. I'm going to say that the outpouring of support from our fans from a game that they've only seen videos of and only a handful have actually played is pretty amazing. And we hope that when the game comes out, that they love it as much as we do, and that they appreciate it as much as we appreciate their love without even playing the game.
I'd second that. It's very surreal to be working on something. And like me and my wife handle handle shipping out all the t-shirts and comics that people buy, and when we go to the post office and we've got this stack of t-shirts and comics for a game that doesn't even exist yet that people are buying, it's pretty insane to think that obviously, you know, this is appealing to people, and it's kind of surreal to think that there's so many people that like it even though there's nothing there yet. Like, it's almost like they just believe, they're having faith in us to give them an awesome game, and I think they'll be very happy. And like Tommy said, yeah, I hope other people feel even remotely the slightest bit the same as we do about this game, because this is something that we're very, very, very proud of, that we literally slaved away for, like, for a very long time, and sacrificed our own personal lives and
health
yeah, and everything to get this thing done, and not only get it done. It wasn't like, hey, let's close the book on this. We need to get this out there so we can make some money. Because, you know, at this point, Tommy was already negative, whatever, you know. The creditors can only call so much.
Yeah, they can only demand so much of money that I don't have.
Yeah, so it's like, it wasn't about just getting it out there and getting it done. It was about making the best possible game that we could. And really just sacrificing everything to make the perfect game. And, I think we did a really good job, and I'm very proud of what we've done. Very, very proud of what we've done. And hopefully other people will understand why we're so proud of our work very soon.
I don't like Edmund.
It's a hard thing to take, because I'm actually a fan of Tommy. So.
Yeah, it's a really weird relationship we have, but whenever I'm at Edmund's house, I'm constantly sighing and rolling my eyes at how stupid he is.
Yeah,
but he's always trying to, like, give me gifts and stuff.
Yeah, whenever, in the background, whenever I'm like, I'm talking about Tommy, or I'll say something like, wow, Tommy, good job, and then I'll hear in the background Tommy goes,
yeah.
He's a dick, but I don't know, I just can't. He's like a bad boy is what
I am the bad boy in this relationship.
I just can't get enough. It's just I take the abuse, because I feel he gives enough sweetness. It's like sometimes maybe I'll say something, I'll look out of the corner of my eye, and he'll be smiling just a little bit, and I'll think, oh, in my heart, you know.
But actually, I'm just smiling at something I'm seeing on TV.
Ah, it's horrible. No problem.
Yeah, we like taking time to do things. It gets us away from our psychosis for at least a couple minutes.